It appears that Chris Borich is impervious to heat. An early season charge by Walker Fowler and intense pressure at our last race in Indiana couldn't rattle the champ. Can he stay hot? Loretta Lynn's is next. Welcome to RacerTV.com's coverage of the AMSOIL Grand National Cross Country Series and AMA National Championship. Jason Wygant here, your host for this, the Parts Unlimited Loretta Lynn's GNCC. Good to see this event back. Had a little break, didn't race here last year, but basically in the better part of 30 years, we've been competing at this venue, of course famous not only as the home of the country music legend, but also for its motocross exploits with both bikes and ATVs in August. But here in the springtime, we're going cross-country ATV racing. Chris Borich, Walker Fowler, they're the ones to watch. Fowler on the number two wants to become number one in the worst way. Been his best pro season so far. And don't forget Adam McGill on the 521, Chris Bithell. The usual suspects also this year joined by a glut of young talent who begin to challenge the old guard more and more each week. So we'll drop the hammer and go racing here at Loretta's. Twin Air DeRisi Racing, whole shot money on the line, and McGill raises his hand and says, I got it. He's got himself a whole shot. Haven't seen many good starts for McGill this year, so that's gonna feel good on the CST Tires Racing Power Sports Pirate MX back machine. He's got Chris Borich right behind him. Borich also much improved on his starts, really going back about a year now. That Borich started pulling hole shots. We never used to see him do that. So these guys are off to the races. Most of you probably familiar with this Loretta Lynn's terrain. If you're not, though, we've got some hard terrain up in the hills, and the motocross track has some clay on it as well. But the majority of the woods here are actually somewhat sandy and whooped out. You also have some small shale rocks, which work almost like sand as well. So this course will get very rough and booped out, and that comes to ultimate challenge here. Not the most technically demanding circuit, as McGill takes his hands off the bars again to celebrate. I don't think you're going to see riders getting stuck here on the hills or in mud or rock gardens or anything today, but you will see some flat-out speeds and everyone just seeing who can hang on the longest and the fastest in the rough stuff. Right now, McGill looking good. Borich back there in second. He'll take that. How about the kids? Bryson Neal here, the number nine. Solid in third. Jay Shadron. Got his distinctive headlights there on the Yamaha. Then it's Landon Wolf and Chris Bithell. Let's give you the XC slow-mo replay. It's our whole shot today. This brought to you by Rocky Mountain ATV MC. It is McGill. Fist pumping. Gets his hands back on the bars so he can pull on the clutch and the front brake. And now the Twin Air DeRisi Racing whole shot. Extra money for him, but most importantly, track position, control the pace up front now. They cruise down this hill. And boys, we thank you for clearing out some of the leaves. Here we go, ground control. Maybe send them into my backyard every winter after the fall foliage drops. As they all drop down this hill, you can see Bithell at the back of the train at the number four. He's not happy about this. He wants to be up there with these guys. He is going to have to hustle because look at Borich. He's starting to push the pace from second. Trying to go after McGill for the lead. These guys are working their way to the top. That's still Landon Wolf and Bithell. Fans in the woods cheering McGill. Definitely a crowd favorite. Always having a good time out there. Multiple fist pumps and a lot of hooting and hollering. And a nice lead. The lead duo has built up, so that'll make McGill even happier. There's the kids. Still, no, we have one pass made. Bithell has got around Wolf. Bryson Neal and Shadron still in front of them. every week I feel like the kids get a little bit closer and stay up there a little bit longer. But with a lap of the books, it is Adam McGill leading away. McGill Mafia has to be happy about this with the Orange Bandits. Like their shot at taking him down. Stay with us.
Twins have notoriously been very hard on crankshafts because that big long stroke of those two cylinders just flexes the crankshaft around. So we were seeing bearing issues. Research development people at AMSOIL could show us that it was likely an oil problem. And they were correct, that was the issue. Instead of having to redesign the engine, I just had to do a better quality oil.
Racer TV is brought to you by AMSOIL. By Rocky Mountain ATV MC. And by Can-Am. Adam McGill. Fast today. And the fans appreciate this effort, keeping Chris Borich and the rest of the AMSOIL Grand National Cross Country Field at bay and having a good time doing it. But you gotta feel that the storm is coming. You know that Borich isn't going to just sit back idly by, and we'll see if anyone else can make a move. Usually the radar is out on Walker Fowler. Slow start for him today. He was seventh at the end of the first lap. Now watch this guy. The four of Bithel on the move. He has cleared the kids. Neil, Wolf, Shadron, and now we see Fowler has caught that move as well. So Bithel made the passes he needed to make, and now he's going to go into all-out blitz mode. There he is at the number four, to try to catch that lead duo. And then we'll put tabs on his four-pack here. These guys are going at it. Fowler, again, at the back of the train, needs to make some passes if he wants any shot at these guys. And you know he's frustrated the way things have gone this year. Fowler got a victory early. Looked to be challenging Borich points. Had a rough go of it at Steel Creek in North Carolina. Got held up by some lap traffic while running up front. Lost a lot of points. And he's been in comeback mode ever since. And it's not going to be easy to make up ground on these guys. They are hauling. Same thing for Bithel. He is on the move. And I think he's closed the gap. Let's go a little bit further back. Still have Neil, Wolf, Shadron. Glad Shadron runs the headlights. That'll really come in handy in one of these mud races and figuring out who is who. As we go back to McGill. Got primo terrain and weather conditions here at Loretta Lynn's. There's a threat of rain all weekend long, but it's looking pretty good. Borich, what? Is it infectious? Is it contagious? Look at this crew member there, shrugging his shoulders, putting his hands up, saying, what are you doing? Maybe he just saw McGill fist pumping his way around the course and decided he wanted to do the same. As everyone else continues to battle, I think Bithel already went by, might have missed him. The rest of this group, no change in the order. No change up front, but this is familiar turf. Borich just sitting there in striking distance. Not quite close enough where he's getting roosted or dusted, but certainly close enough where if he needs to make up ground, he's only going to make up about 10 feet to have a shot at the lead. All right, one pass has been made now by Fowler. He's around Shadron. Dropping down into this ditch. Still McGill and Borich. And I gotta say it again, look at this dirt and these trails. It is primo today, and look at Bithel closing the gap. They're working their way uphill. The lead group, and look, Fowler has closed the gap. Not easy today. He's getting bucked all over the place, but may find himself within striking distance. As McGill forages a line through the woods, he's got the two Suzuki boys, Killer Bees, second and third, and big credit to this rider, Biffle. He has come from way back, and now that he's gotten around the Neil, Wolf, Shadron trio, Fowler is going to try to do the same. Biffle coming by now. I think he might be the fastest rider on the track. He has got this thing going. See if Fowler can do anything about it. Into the pit. Everyone is stopping for fuel. Let's see about goggles here. Doesn't look like McGill is changing anything, including his position on the track. That's the lead. But Biffle is around Boric and up to second.
Sometimes you come across something so different, you just have to stop and check it out. The Rocky Mountain ATV MC website has everything you need, from our huge selection of tires, ATV and UTV accessories, and OEM parts, to our online chat, customer reviews, and instructional videos. Our extensive inventory means most orders arrive in 3 days or less. Get low prices, quick shipping, and incredible customer service. RockyMountainATVMC.com. Get ready.
Racer TV is brought to you by AMSOIL. By Rocky Mountain ATV MC. And by Can-Am. Give you the highlights here of the Can-Am 4x4 Pro Class. This is by far the most competitive championship we have going this season. You throw all these riders who have won titles in multiple 4x4 divisions in years past, throw them into one class, it has been action-packed. You had Kevin Trantham leading the way early. Got the Can-Am X team taking on riders like Robert Smith, who's right there in the green on the Big Nuts racing machine. Michael Swift backed by Factory Polaris in the hunt. Cold Cock Whiskey Polaris rider Rick Checo. Great racing in that division. In the end, Brian Buchanan backed by ATV Parts Plus would take his first win of the season. And incredibly, that's four different winners in that class in six rounds. And good to see Buchanan, who's done plenty of winning before in the 4x4 open division, getting his groove on now. He'll be one to watch all season long. Back to our pro race, Chris Biffle. What a charge by the number four. He was at the back of the train early in this one. Well, I guess that's better than Walker Fowler, who wasn't even on the train on the first lap. He has come all the way back to pass the best of the best and lead it here in Tennessee. Boric up to second, and Adam McGill third. Let's see how McGill responds. He's led the majority of this thing. It could change in a hurry if the two Killer Bees hook up and take the pace to another level, and they have stretched it out over McGill just a little bit. We'll see if McGill can get back in the hunt. I think what Biffle has done, they always give this advice, it's easier said than done. They'll say, you know, when you're making this charge from the back, once you get the lead, try to maintain that pace and you'll pull away from these guys. Sounds simple, right? Well, it did get him all the way to the front, but it's hard to pull away from Chris Boric. He is now hanging back there in second. Just like he did with McGill. And anytime you have the champ on your rear tires, well, that means he's got a shot, because he likes to make these passes in the last lap. Well, McGill is hanging tough. I thought they might drop him once they started riding in formation, the Killer Bees, but McGill maybe taking a little bit of a breather after pushing so hard and leading this thing. This is to see Fowler come through in fourth. Big downhill, and Boric has really tightened it up on Biffle. No change in the order. Boric still hanging in there, keeping the heat on. And McGill is still close too. We'll see if Fowler can make it a four-rider duel down the stretch. Still don't see him back there. He give you an idea of the gap. There is the number two. So he still has some ground to make up. Onto the motocross track. You can hear the familiar sounds of Rodney Thompson, our live event announcer, calling the action. Now the riders are behind the billboards. You can see photos of some of the great motocross riders who have come here and raced as amateurs. They've been on to spectacular pro careers. But this is the top of the line in cross-country racing, and Chris Biddle has walked through them all to take over the lead. Oh, but Chris Borich just lurking. I don't know how many tons of dust Chris Borich has taken on over the years, running in second place for three of the four laps. Today, five of the six. This looks comfortable anyway.
What do you call a machine that combines precision engineered handling, industry-leading power, and a rider-focused design? We call it a Can-Am. From the essentials to fully loaded, you'll find that same combination in every ATV and side-by-side we build. And right now, get your own for as low as $149 a month. Can-Am, the ride says it all.
Racer TV is brought to you by AMSOIL, by Rocky Mountain ATV MC, and by Can-Am. Not much time left in this. Round six of the AMSOIL Grand National Cross Country Series, and it is on the Killer Bees, Biddle and Borich. Pulled away a bit from everyone else. Now Biddle had to come from way, way back to grab the lead on the number four. I have to wonder if all that charging, all those passes he made, will that take a little out of him down the stretch? Borich with the good start, he was just cruising. Saved a lot of energy early on, so let's see if Biddle can prevent Borich from doing the Borich. I saw these guys down in Florida. Biddle led the majority of that opening round, and then Biddle tells me, yep, he Boriched me. That's just how it goes in these final laps. They know what's going to happen. The champ's going to find something special. We'll see if McGill in third can respond, if Biddle can do anything in the lead. And still Fowler has not given up. Got a long way to go. He is trying hard to catch these guys. Biddle still maintaining the lead, though. McGill's in contention, and Fowler, I think, is finally there to maybe have a shot at the podium. There he is. Boy, the kid is really going strong on this final lap. So two different things to watch. Fowler and McGill trying to close the gap on these two. And Biddle, who you know, knows that it is coming from Borich. The champ's not just going to sit there. Fowler's still not close enough. Here it is. Chris Biddle continuing to maintain the lead. Where is a line for Borich? You know he's got one or two of them picked out. Borich people on the side of the track are happy. McGill right there. Fowler now in the picture. It's about as close as the top four have been all day long. Oh, my bad. That was a lap rider. That is Fowler. So he still has some ground to make up. And now Borich into the lead. Unbelievable. The guy follows his own script brilliantly. And even though they know it's coming, they're unable to stop it. Now Fowler is a little bit closer. All right, Chris Biddle, Adam McGill, Walker Fowler, let's see if you've got something to get the champion back on the final lap. And Borich is starting to motor away. Borich had won three in a row coming into this one, looking for four straight. And look at the changeup. McGill and Fowler on a roll here. Fowler has a shot at second place. And now the champion has uncorked it. Putting the power down to the ground on his Maxxis Suzuki. This is the fight for second. What happened to Biddle? I've got to wonder if that strong pace he ran early, it was a valid effort to come from behind, but did it take too much out of him? These guys are right there. And now they've put distance on Fowler again. Two or three times I thought that the number two was going to be there. And then he loses a little bit of ground. Oh, which way is this going to go? It's the big four of GNCC, and three spots on the podium are available. Here's Borich going to work on it. Out of the tight stuff now, opening it up for the final time. Let's put some tabs on these guys behind him. It is now McGill and Fowler. Onto the motocross track for the last time. It's the number one plate hitting it first. Chris Borich, no surprise, got the Maxxis Suzuki dialed in. And he did it in grand style, waiting to the last lap as usual. Look at these two going for it for second, McGill and Fowler. It's going to come down to the wire. Different lines out here in the moto track. Woo, wheel to wheel. McGill takes the inside away from Fowler, so Fowler switches outside to try to get him back. Borich has got the checkered flag. All eyes on this battle for the runner-up spot. Oh, Fowler trying to back it in from outside to inside. Not enough room. McGill takes second. What a race. Took 2 hours to settle that one, guys. Unbelievable. Chris Borich gets it done again. We'll show you the AMSOIL results. Pitbull. Again, I think that valiant effort in the mid part of the race took it out of him down the stretch. He's fourth. McClure up to fifth. Neil Wolf, the other Wolf, Brian Wolf, Shadron, and Pickens round out of the top 10. And Borich doing serious damage to the points. Now well over a one race lead on Fowler. That's what 4 wins in a row will do for you. McGill sliding past Biffle now for third. AMSOIL race recap. Great start for Adam McGill, and he looked comfortable up front. Some riders don't like leading these things in the early laps. No problem for him. Hammer down. Did have Chris Borich camped out on his rear tires most of the way. Chris Biffle would be the one on the move, though. There you see him. He'd come from way back to get third, and then second, and then go all the way to the lead until the last lap when Chris Borich did his thing. Takes it away from Biffle, who had some problems on the last lap. Couldn't maintain the pace quite the same as these two. McGill and Fowler, who get by him and take the second place battle to the wire. Great racing today. Thanks for watching.